Okay, now I'm gonna go deep into the Thierry Henry player's career. And yeah, I'm using non-copyrighted video from the commercial with Thierry Henry. And yeah, I'm not gonna bother seeing it. I just want to copy that I have, like, what was like 13 minutes is enough to go into details. Okay, so let's go his youth career. He started in youth career, he changed like 5 clubs. In 92, at the age of, I guess, it was like 15 or 14, he became member of the youth team of Monaco, and he probably in 16 or 17 years old made his professional debut, and he scored 3 goals. First season, I think I remember that correctly. He was number 13, and then in the second season, that's 94-95, he was 16 or 17. He also scored 3 goals, but they gave him the desired number 12. And then skip to 97, 96, 97, I don't know how he scored 9 goals. That's the most of. He had like 19 or 18 years old. Yeah, 19 at the end of the season. And then 97, 98, he scored 4 goals. That was enough to get a call from the French national team and play with probably the best attacking midfielder of all time. Is my top 11 video. You can see that Zinedine Zidane is not a captain, but he's the top. He's definitely, I don't know if he's the second best, but obviously midfield there's no competition. I mean, yes, Schneider, Van der Vaart, they're caca. I don't think if Rivaldo, you can consider him offensive midfielder, consider him second striker, but okay, never mind. He won the French he won, let's see. Oh no, he started in 97, so I guess, yeah, the year he scored 9 goals. But in the World Cup he scored 3 goals in 10 appearances. It was all in the World Cup. And yeah, from there I'm gonna go up and down with the club and national team career. In the 1998, he played half season, he scored only 1 goal. And then the second half of the season, 99, let's see, 99, season 1998, second half, he scored more, three goals. He was number 6 then in Juventus, and I think he played with Zinedine Zidane. I think Zizou, or he, w I don't know. I should check it right on the community page if I make it wrong, but I think he might have played with Zinedine Zidane. Yeah, I think he definitely played. And then with his half season, not really disappointing. 3 goals. I think they probably paid him off position. And then he went to Arsenal. And he was like, "Fuck you all! I'm the king of the Premier League." He scored 17 goals in his first season. He started at probably 21 with 22, 20, 22, 23 at the end. Let's see. No, 22, 21, 22. Yeah, 21, 22, 10, 23. And then the second season, same, 17. And then the season 24, he scored 24, 2001, 2002. And this is very important. Okay, yeah, 99, 2000. He was 17 goals first season in Arsenal. And in French national team, he scored 5 goals. I don't know how much in Euro. I need to check this. But he won the Euro 2000. They sort of defended their title as world champions, and I think he scored like a winning penalty, a great winning penalty. And then okay, let's see Arsenal. Yes, season 2002-2003. I know how he didn't become a captain. Sorry, Patrick Vieira. He'll be in my top 32 players. Third substitute. I think I'm gonna put Edgar Davids as substitute for Steven Gerrard. But the thing is, I don't know if I put Patrick Vieira, I think Lampard is a great offensive, Gattuso. I can put everyone. I don't know if I put Vieira, he barely in my 32 team. And I don't think he deserves a captain armband. He's 1 year older than Andre. It makes no sense. Andre scored 24 goals and 20 assists. He was one goal short from Ruud van Nistelrooy, and he didn't manage to, if he scored one more goal because he assisted, because he was leading an assist and Arsenal were champions, he will take golden boots from 2001 to 2006. And yeah, the most golden boots were two years in a row. 130 goals 2003-2004 and 25 goals even in 4-1 2010 World Cup winner. And I think they both have golden boot or something like that. It's strange. I think Andrei should just take the golden boot. He has more assists than Diego Forlan. Don't shit on me. Okay. So yeah, and it was really disastrous season 2001-2002. It's not the season when he scored the most assist record, but the season he scored 3 goals in 2002. But the France, I don't know, someone say. The reason is Zidane, no, one player can do it. France, after Zidane got sent off, played better. I mean, yeah. 2002, the reason for France not qualifying for a knockout phase, not scoring a goal, losing for South Africa, for Christ's sake, is Domenech. Domenech, I know. The guy who didn't manage to score a goal, and then because he has the best team in 2006 score they went to final because of the team, not that he was awful. Okay, and then yeah, Arsenal first year as a captain 2005-2006 he scores 27 goals. He was the best scorer in Premier League, and then I think this should be his third golden boot, because at that time Juventus have an incident for fixing games, and guess who won a golden boot? Luca Toni, the guy in the Italian league. Fuck you, Andrei should have a hat-trick of golden boots, and should have a bit. Should be a better best player in 2005-2006 for sure, and 2002-2003 as a captain, as a someone who should be a captain. And 2006-2007 it was too much for him. He was the final in the Champions League, the same way in the Champions League and the World Cup. The best position player in the team got sent off. The second best probably in the team. First was Jens Lehmann as a goalkeeper, the record holder to this day in Champions League, and the second was the captain Zinedine Zidane, and it was too much. He was too depressed, basically haven't played for half a season, and then scored 10 goals in 17 appearances. It was great. Barcelona saw that, they saw that he overcome his depression, and they want to sign him in 2006-2007. Yeah. But they signed him here, and he scored 12 goals in his first season in Barcelona. It wasn't enough, apparently, but Guardiola still, despite being a little bit douchey and put Ibrahimovic alone, have a talk with him, and he make one good season with 19 goals. I think in pre-season, the first and the third one season, he won the Champions League. The only title missing in this in his roster, and then he went in New York Red Bulls, and he basically played half a season there. He scored 2 goals in 11 appearances, and then 14, 15, 10 in 10. And he was the best player in, and then, 2011-2012 season, I think it was 2012, in 4, in 7 appearances, he scored 2 goals, 1 in a week, and 1, I think it's in the FA Cup. And he has a pretty good career, I mean, how many goals? 360, when the most of his career he was in the top of competition, unlike Pele, who basically played with idiots. And he had 51 goals in France. And he also scored with the youth team under 20, 3 goals. So basically he scores, over 400 goals, which is very impressive for the great player, a great man. And he will be forever in our hearts, and I'll miss him, I don't know about you. I just love him to death. I mean, he's a great person, a great player, and he will be a great manager if he take baby steps. And that's it, goodbye.
Doesn't need a cage. And this time, first to 100 wins.